That dream began here, in the small town of Pewaukee, Wisconsin. On March 22, 1989, Justin James Watt was born with a middle name that honored his paternal grandfather.
Whoa, I better move way back for JJ. He's tall.
JJ would be the eldest of three strapping boys with a father who was a firefighter and a mother who was a building operations vice president.
Just seeing how hard they worked and seeing that kind of blue collar mentality that they took to life really set in on my brothers and I.
I always had the mentality that I wouldn't push them.
Come on.
My saying at the time was always, I'll never expect you to be perfect, but I always expect you to try to be perfect.
All right, look at you. You're riding a bike.
I focused more on the school academic side as well. My kids did homework in the summertime.
You made them do homework in the summertime?
I did.
Wow.
I did. They had to read, and then they would write a report. An hour a day.
In the summertime?
Absolutely.
For you?
Hey, you stay there. No.
I started skating when I was 3 years old. My parents took me to the ice rink, and I started skating and fell in love with hockey. And I really do think that playing hockey at a young age was big in my athletic development.
Hockey may have been his first love, but growing up in Wisconsin meant idolizing the Green Bay Packers and their defensive standout, Reggie White. When JJ was seven, he stated his ambition to become a football player.
When I was in fifth grade, and I'd go to the pep rally, and I'd watch the seniors do the dance with the cheerleaders. That's the coolest thing ever. Like, he's a starting quarterback, he gets to dance with a cheerleader. Like, it's a cool life.
Did you think to yourself, that's gonna be me someday?
That was the goal, yeah.
His first goal, to play at the University of Wisconsin.
I shared my dreams with my parents. I shared my dreams with an elementary school teacher.
Mrs. Keefe.
Yeah, Mrs. Keefe.
And he looked up at me with his baby blues and his blonde hair, and he said, Mrs. Keefe, I'd really like to play for the Badgers. And then he said, I really want to be in the NFL. Working hard, his drive, he had it.
I've had plenty of adults throughout my childhood tell me that my dreams are too big, that my dreams were unrealistic. I've had teachers tell me that my dreams were unrealistic. She said I could do it. She believed in me.
The first step in that dream, to make a name for himself, began at Pewaukee High School.
Tall, lanky kid, kind of on knees and elbows. But I'll say this, he was a good athlete because he was always a competitor. And he got that from his dad and from his grandfather.
My grandpa was the biggest fan in the world of my brothers, Pewaukee in general.
My dad could not have been more proud. He would sit up on the top seat of the bleachers right in front of the press box. JJ would always be able to look up and know that he was up there.
From that grandstand, his grandfather would watch while JJ competed for the quarterback position.
You know, it was a good competition up until one practice, a two-a-day in August, and we're trying to throw the bubble screen.
So all you have to do is turn and throw it right to the guy on the side.
If you had a receiver run down the field full speed on a zero route, you could hit him at 50 yards without any problem. But he could not turn to the side and throw a little bubble route to save his life.
Yeah, JJ was struggling with that bubble screen.
So I lost the job, and the next day I was a...
This message is transmitted at the request of the United States Office of Civil Defense at 3:40 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. NORAD detected a long-range nuclear missile launch in North Korea. This missile is believed to be headed in the direction of the Los Angeles metropolitan area. It is believed that it will impact this area within the next 1.5 to 2 hours. All residents within a 400-mile radius of this area should seek a fallout shelter immediately. Fallout is a product of nuclear attacks. Prolonged exposure to fallout will result in certain death. Fallout spreads across large areas approximately 1 minute after impact. If you cannot find a fallout shelter in your area, local authorities will lead you to one. Take a battery-powered radio and all essential supplies with you to the fallout shelter. Tune to 770 AM on your radio for emergency information while in the fallout shelter. Sheltering in place is not advised, as your survival cannot be ensured. In that scenario, President Obama will be speaking on all television and radio stations shortly. All television and radio stations in the United States will now cease their regular programming to carry this special message from the President and to report on the news of this incident.